a snake in the grass that does not want us to follow God. If you have a Bible, please turn to Genesis 3, 1 through 6. Now the serpent was more crafty than any of the wild animals the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, did God really say you must not eat from any tree in the garden? The woman said to the serpent, we may eat fruit from the trees in the garden, but God said you must not eat from the tree that is in the middle of the garden. And you must not touch it, or you will die. You will not certainly die, the serpent said to the woman, for God knows that when you eat, when your eyes will open, will be opened, and will be like God, knowing good and evil. When the woman saw the fruit of the trees, of the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eye, and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it. She also gave some to her husband who was with her and ate it. Who is this snake? The Bible says he is the evil one. Revelation 20, verse 2 says, and he sees the dragon, the ancient serpent, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. This ancient serpent does not want us to follow God, still today in 2013. It seems so easy often to follow Satan's temptations rather than following God. What can be done about this? If you will, please turn to James 4, 7 through 8. Submit yourselves then to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Now can the scripture help us to not get caught by the serpent of the grass? Submit yourself to God. Ecclesiastes 12, verse 13 says, the end of the matter, all has been heard. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. The Bible says that we must be hearers and doers of the word. James 1, verse 22 says, but be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. It's like looking into a mirror, seeing your hair is messy, corn in your teeth, toothpaste on your lip, and not doing anything to clean it up. That is being a hearer only. A doer will clean up the mess. Resist the devil. We must try our hardest not to sin. We must hate sin and truly desire to follow God. Even if we do sin, we are sad that we did it and want to try even harder to follow Jesus. We must want to walk into the light. The devil is real, and if we do not believe that, we will not resist him. Drown your